Hello everyone, I just wanted to give you a short video here, just kind of taking you through the ins and outs of Schoology, which is going to be something that you and your parents are both going to use exclusively throughout the year. So if you are with your parents right now, that's great. If your parents aren't around, ask them if they're interested in coming over and watching, because it is going to be valuable for them and you. It's a one-stop shop for kind of everything we're trying to do. So if they're not with you, pause it and go get them, or at least ask them. If they don't want to, that's fine, but it's going to be something that I think both parent and child should be aware of. So the first thing is everything you're going to do is going to go through MyOLSD. Okay, now I'm assuming yours looks just like this. I can't really get on it from a student's end, but I'll show you what mine looks like, and it's basically the same thing. So first of all, obviously you log in, which you should already know your login information, and if you don't, we'll get that to you, but you should have it by now, okay? You're going to come to this right here, and you're going to see that yours might look a little bit different up here as mine does, but basically it's the same thing. You're going to have PowerSchool here where you can check grades. You're going to have Google Docs, Google Drive, where you can save stuff and you can do use Google Docs and that kind of thing. You'll learn more about that later. But the one thing I wanted to focus on in this video is Schoology, because it's going to be something that everybody has to be aware of, and it's something that's going to be used exclusively. Now, when you come into Schoology, if you're not familiar with this, it looks a lot like Facebook, or at least very similar. That's kind of how it's set up to try to be user-friendly, I guess, and something we're used to. And you're going to come right when you come to like what's called your home page, it's going to show your recent activity. So what that is that's going to show any course that you're in, any teacher that you're following, their stuff is going to come up here. Now, mine would look different than yours probably. Like this teacher right here, this is Miss Wood, and I doubt her stuff might show up on yours, but it's obviously it's nothing. It's just showing that she installed this stuff through Schoology, so it's no big deal. But like this one, Mr. McDaniels posted this to Olin Tangi Shanahan, so everybody would see this because every student at Shanahan would be able to see this. Okay, and there's other things that I might have on here that not everybody would see. Like this one here, Mrs. Fields put something to Olin Tangi local schools, which means that's every teacher in Olin Tangi can see that. Okay, not just Shanahan, but any teacher. So all of our recent activities are going to look a little bit different. So what I like to focus on is this courses tab right here. Okay, now when you open up your child's courses, it's going to look a little different than mine. They're going to show social studies, science, and so on. It's going to show all their classes. Obviously, mine shows four math classes because I teach four math classes and an advisory. Okay, and anything I post to Schoology, anything that I post, like if I put that I installed these, if I posted it to these courses right here, then you would be able to see it on your recent activity. But whoops, I want to just mainly focus here only on the fact that I'm looking at courses here. So I'm going to click on one of my courses. Now, when I click on this, it's going to have nothing because this is this year's course, and obviously I have not done anything with this year's course, so there's nothing here. So what I've done is I pulled up last year's class to kind of show you what it truly looks like. And this was my second period last year. I have no idea why my picture is a picture of Tom Brady, but it is. I didn't do that. It somehow just changed on its own. I just now noticed. So pay no mind to that. But regardless, you can see last year on May 21st, I posted Bring Pen or Sharpie for Yearbook Signing. And then I had a video a couple weeks prior to that. And it goes, it gets older as you go down. Okay, so obviously the most current would be at the top. So it's just a little post, and I try to use this every single day, and I know the other team teachers do as well. We try to post what the homework is for that night, if there's a test coming up, so on and so forth. That's kind of the plan. So that's why I tell my students, they should never say, I forgot I had this or I forgot I had that. Because getting on Schoology should be it should become something that happens every single day right when they get home from school, or you know, maybe in the evening, whenever they're able to do homework. But they should always jump on Schoology to get what they need. Okay? And it's something that even parents can jump on and know the logins and all that, so that they can jump on it if they want to kind of make sure that their son or daughter is doing what they need to be doing. So that's what that is. So that's in the updates tab. I mean, that's just like your newsfeed. That's no different than the home screen when you see everything. But if you just want to see, I want to go to the math section, or I want to go to the math and I just want to go to updates, that's how you do it. You click there. Okay. The next thing I want to draw attention to is going to this. Let me go back over to the, if I can find it, materials section. Okay, so now I'm in materials section, and like I said, this is my class from last year, but this is kind of a I don't even know really what to call it, but it's just where you can find pretty much anything, a paper that your son or daughter might have lost or anything, and it's something that I guess we'll take away that, you know, where you have to email in, oh, my son lost his review sheet that I have. Is there any way he can have an extra day, or can you email it to me? You don't have to do that because it should be here. Okay, so if I go into chapter one, this is from last year. There you see, there's some extra worksheets there that can be pulled up. There's the notes. So a lot of times students will, if you don't know by now, my classroom operates as a flipped classroom, which means that they watch videos as homework and they do the quote-unquote homework or activities. They do those in class, so it's like it's flipped, obviously. So I have notes that go with my videos that the students will watch, and you can come on here, you can print them. If you don't have a printer, at least you can have them, okay, if they forget them. So we should really never have that, I couldn't do my video because I didn't have my notes, because they're here. They're always going to be in that folder. So the materials tab, that's somewhere to always find it. I know Mrs. Godfrey, the English teacher, she always puts stuff in here, and I'm certain that the other teachers do as well. We all really try to use it because we want to give the students as much. We know stuff happens. We know that things get lost or misplaced or whatever, and it's nice to have somewhere where you can go in and get a new one. And I know a lot of times we'll see parents bringing their kid back up in the evening because they forgot something. Well, hopefully this can kind of alleviate some of those situations, hopefully. So it's all here. Like I said, my classroom, I have videos, learning videos, that the students are going to be required to watch. Here was my videos last year from chapter one. As you can see, I put all the videos in here. So, you know, if there's a specific topic like 6 and 7, learning target 6 and 7, they can go in and they can rewatch the video. One thing that I emphasize when studying is, you know, math is great if you just want to, you know, if I could give any student a worksheet and say, hey, go finish these problems for, if you wanted to get better at it, here. Well, if they don't know how to do it, then how are they going to do it correctly unless they have a help from a parent? And again, with these videos, they can turn on a video, I won't actually hit play here, but you could flip it on, and they can do every problem that they're seeing me do. They just pause it, try it, and then get to watch me give the feedback on it to make sure they're doing it correctly or if they're doing it incorrectly. So that's a great way to study. So all those are going to be, again, in the materials section. So those are really the only two that matter. This other stuff here really doesn't matter to you all. So I'm really concentrated there, the updates and this. And like I said, the homepage comes up with everything. It'll have Mr. Glassburn's homework, Mrs. Savely's, Mrs. Godfrey's stuff. So when you click on courses, you can break it down individually by the class and see what's going on. Okay. And I like to think that I do a pretty good job of keeping this thing updated. So if you kind of want to stay in the loop of what's going on in math, stay up on Schoology, because that's going to be the best way to kind of keep tabs on your son or daughter. So one more thing I want to show you is the messaging tab. This is a great feature. I love this feature. You can go up to the little envelope up here. As you can see, I got some unread emails. So if I go to new message there, whoops, didn't mean to do that. And let's say your son or daughter is watching one of my videos or is studying for a test, and they say, Mr. Harrison, I just really don't understand this topic. Okay, and they can message me this, and I'll get it on my phone, and I'll also get it through email. And it's just a great way to let me know, okay, well then, can you come in early to school tomorrow? Can we meet at lunch? Did you try going back and watching that video on it, or whatever? There's different ways the communication is so nice. It doesn't have to be to where they get there the next morning and it's like, I didn't understand this. They can let me know ahead of time, and maybe we can kind of get a plan in place to allow them to have better success. So if they're coming in here to send a message, they just got to know how to spell my name. So probably best to probably search my first name because it's not the most popular name. So, and there I am. And there's other people as well, but there I am. Or if you want to do Mrs. Godfrey, probably would make more sense to do her last name. Okay, and there you can see Mrs. Godfrey, and you can send her directly a message saying, "Mr. or Mrs. Godfrey, I'm struggling with this. Is there any way we can talk during advisory, or during lunch, or before school?" Okay, so and that kind of just lets us know. We try to do our best at replying to these messages. Don't always accomplish it. I know I coach, and Mr. Glassburn also coaches, and all four of us have families at home too. So we try, but there are things that get in the way of that as well. But at least the communication is there. And my favorite part about it is the fact that the students are taking responsibility for themselves and really saying, "I don't understand this. I'm going to seek the teacher out." And I think that is a skill that maybe a lot of sixth graders maybe struggle with a little bit, at least some of them. So that's something to kind of, something to be able to do. Another thing, if a student is sick from school, I had many times where I'd get a message halfway through the day and it'd say, "Hey, Mr. Garrison, I'm out sick today. Is there anything I'm missing, or is there anything I need to do for tomorrow?" And that is just, that's cool because that shows me they're taking responsibility for themselves, and they message me, and then I'm able to go in, send a message and say, "Okay, well then I'll send this to whoever the name of the person is," and then I can attach worksheets, I can attach videos, I can do whatever. So, essentially they can miss school because they're sick and still not get behind if they're capable or up to it to actually do work. But if they're not, obviously that's fine. But the worst part about being sick is getting behind in any, whether you're a student or you're just in your job. There's nothing worse than being behind. So that's something that's a good thing to really use that messaging tool that way. Parents, you're more than welcome, obviously, to email us. That's the best way probably for parents and teachers to communicate. You can also message us here. I had parents do it last year, but I would say maybe it's a little bit easier to message through email so that I have your email. And well, it doesn't really matter, but usually email's the way it works. So I think that's pretty much it. So any questions you might have, let me know. But it's really a good thing, and it's going to be something that they're going to use every single day, and we want them to, and we're going to use it every single day. So thank you.